Hello everybody, how you doing? I see that the reminders went out today. Oh, I'm so happy everything worked. Well, almost everything. You know, you just can't have anything too perfect. Come on, we're crafters. So let's see who's here today. I mean, oh my goodness, we're already full up. And what did I do with my glasses? I'm gonna have the right glasses on today. Susan, Laura, oh my goodness. Yeah, let's get a nice little weather report. I mean, it is raining here, but it's in the 50s. So, I mean, to me, it's just like my hometown weather in Tacoma, Washington. Now, like I said, things just can't be perfect while you're giving us those weather reports because that still says first Friday. And I wanted it to say this Friday because day after tomorrow is our used stamp sale. Now, last time we threw in a lot of accessories. This time, hey, well, we'll see what we've got because with every purchase, there's a free gift. How about that? So, hey, thank you for sharing, Sheila. I really love it when you share. I love it when you subscribe. You know, if you're on YouTube, just go up to the corner. There's a spot where you can get on my mailing list. Yeah, you can get to my shopping cart if you just have a undesirable urge to go shopping. But, you know, you want to wait until it's over, okay? And then there are links down below. And then those of you who are on Facebook, you'll be able to subscribe and get a, not really subscribe. You know, we love it when you like the dog's page. And, you know, he is in today. He is in today, aren't you, babe? Yes. Yes, I move the cameras around, but yours is not quite there yet. Yep, because you always sit in a different spot. Yeah. Oh, yay, Karen from Pittsburgh is in the house. Now, I got to tell you, I don't know about your day, but the other night, I knew it was time to go to sleep when I put these shoes on. You like them? I have a match set just like them in the closet. Yeah, don't you just love it? So let's see about some weather reports. I'll get some up here real quick. Okay, Paula. Paula says it's raining in Chapel Hill. We've got Iowa. We've got soggy Houston. Oh, golly. And it's raining. Oh, come on. Now I am depressed. It's raining in Puerto Rico. How can that be? We think that you either have beautiful sunshine or else you have hurricanes. You know, I mean, there is no middle. Yeah, there's nothing in the middle. So let's see. Oh, golly, freezy and icy. But you know what? UPS is still delivering because they're bringing me my stuff Friday because it went out today. You just gotta love it. It might seem like a long time, but if you think about it, it really is pretty quick because I think I ordered Monday. It was late Monday. So, you know, you can't count Monday. And, you know, I wasn't surprised it didn't go out Tuesday. So it's going out today. I have it Friday. Life is good. Now, if you live on the East Coast and it takes a little bit longer, I'm sorry. You can always move into a two-day shipping zone. You know, now, I didn't even see if I was, oh, golly, yeah, I might. Things might look a little bit weird here. So we're just going to make it quick today because, and I'm going to show you a card that I did in a swap recently. And most of it you know how to do, but I'm going to show you how to save time with it. But before I hit that, oh my goodness. See, Laura is always looking out for me. She's hitting that like button. Yes. And you know, that's the other thing on YouTube, there's a little bell and you want to click that because, you know, the same thing with Facebook. They have their methods of getting in touch with you, you know, to remind you that we're on. And then as a backup, I have my Stampin Bot system, and that's through Facebook Messenger. And if you're not on that, If you're on Facebook, just type stamp this below, and then we'll send you. We don't use it to advertise for stuff. We only use it to go and send you things just before we go live. Once in a blue moon, you know, like it wouldn't hurt to tell you there's only 6 hours left of the best sale of the year or something, you know, something like that. But 99% of the time, you can ask anyone on here. We just tell you like a minute before we go on and boom. Except for the last two times, for some reason, it didn't work. So, oh my goodness, uneventful. What does that mean? Because, you know, Diane did her first Stampin' Up! Event at a winery. Gotta give the girl some props. Oh, golly. Oh, okay. You know, have any of you ever been to a rainforest? I got to go to a rainforest in Panama. Compliments of Stampin' Up. And it was great. It was very beautiful up there. But, very humid. Very humid. And Tony's on my team, too. So, Karen, Marcy. Boy, you know what? And if you... Let's see. If I might miss somebody. Diane, Karen, Marcy. Who else is on here from my team? I know it's probably just because I didn't see it because they go and rain down on me, you know, they rain down on me. And so if I miss you, you know, that's okay. But we are looking for new members to the team because it's always, great to have more stampers. It's always great to have more stampers. And if it ever just goes in and hits you really hard that you just got to join... And you got to join now. Grab your wish list. And on the Facebook site, all you have to do is type join the fun. This is what you have to type. There, join the fun. Or else go to that website. But either way, let's get started because I have to save my voice for Friday when that big sale is coming. And, you know, golly, he disappeared. No one's here to tell me what to say or do. What shall I do? Oh, golly. So here is my swap card, and I don't want to go and show you all of the stuff from this swap that I did because we were all doing things from that are coming out in March. So I'll show it next week. See, Louise has been on my team. She knows. Yep. So, if you might have noticed, I went and added more light down here so that you could see better. And sometimes it's a little bit too bright, but I think you can see. You can get this now. You can get this now. But what I want to show you, but this is in March, and it's only in March. So those of you who like good deals on greetings, yeah, that would be good. So... Yeah, see, we gave these out, I think it was last month, to the people who bought with us. And then 1 month we gave out these, you know, for our shoppers. You got to hook up the shoppers, right? And, holy moly, where is it? I just saw it. We're giving out these for February. Because, you know, everybody can use some dots, you know, just enough to get them by. And this, you know, it's great to get something cool that you might, you know, you might not have bought for yourself. And then just get enough to go and try it out. Now, can you see the texture in this? Because to me, it seems like it almost has to go like that before you see the texture. I'm still testing it out. You know, I bought two lights. Those of you who think that I'm just rolling in the dough, think again, because I do like to invest in really good stuff so that you can see really well. Yeah. Yeah. Thank you, Sheila. Thank you. So, I don't know if you can see that better, Well, I'm sure you can see it better this way, but when does it wash out for, you know, because what I see is kind of, you know, yeah, yes, I'm sorry, that doesn't, I need a, so it washes out a little bit. Is that what you're saying, Mercy? So I'm going to show you how I did this, and because Cecil and I, you know, Stamper's favorite human, and yes, he's over there. Yep, he's directing hard on us. He's great at doing these big shot things, you know, like put this together. He put he went down with me to Sacramento to, okay, great. Thank you, Marcy. He did all this big shot work. He ran a bunch of these, and then I used the Stamparatus. Oh boy, I am in the last century. He went and cut a bunch of these, and then by using the Stamparatus the way I did, I just went and made a hole, dropped those in there, and then I stamped on them and took them out. And if you don't have this new little take your pick tool, I want to say pick your nose tool. Anyway, if you don't have this, when you're doing that, this really helps a lot, because all you have to do is just, well, here, I'll do it on this. This is one from Master Stamper leftover. See, just that. And that pick takes it out of the template. So we'll work on these lights and get, but it's more important that, you know, I try to get this color right, and I can't control how you do your color, but, you know. So is everybody having a good time today? Are you trying to, you know, we'll just ignore that it could be like 3 feet up in their doorway today. Oh my goodness.
Yes, 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 yes.
So here, this is how I did this really quickly. Have your husband go and do this, right? Because guys like gadgets. Guys like gadgets. That's just the way it is. You know, hey, I like gadgets. I'm a gadget girl. Honey, boy, first time they showed me the big shot, I was like, okay, I'm getting one. Yep. Didn't even know what a dye machine was the first time I saw it. So this is 1.5, and this is, and you notice that I went and ran these through the big shot together. And that keeps that even, and it doesn't disturb the design. You can always just run this through and then put that through, you know, I mean, and then put it on here. But for me, if I put them both together, I know that, you know, this won't shrink and that'll stay the same. So, yeah. Does that make sense? I hope it does. And then, so this is 1.5 and it's by 5.5. And I just put two of them side by side, and I was able to knock out 22 cards rather quickly. Now, these are the three colors I used. I used Blushing Bride, right? I used Blackberry Bliss, and I used, oh yeah, our favorite old olive that goes with everything. And this is the stamp set that you can get with a $100 order. This and the designer series paper, which I've been cleaning in here because one of the fire victims had asked for some scrapbooking supplies. Oh, honey, she's gonna get like a box full of some old designer series papers, because, you know, they don't go old. Scrappers, you know, you love that stuff. So anyway, you can get this, those two together, and, well, sorry, I've been sworn to secrecy until March 1st, so I can't tell you more than that. But this, yeah, this and the designer series paper, and I picked this color combo because it wasn't on the designer series paper, right? I just thought, because other people, okay, I will show you two things from that swap, okay? Oh, wait. See, this is from the designer series paper. Now, you can't get this yet, but that's from the designer series paper. And see, oh, look at dot, dot, dot. Yep. And then, hold on. This is using the designer series paper, too. But you see this, not in that, those two color combinations, which were prevalent on the designer series paper. So let's get back to this. I put two 1.5 by 5.5 inch pieces of Very Vanilla side by side. And I started with the biggest one because they are all pretty much the same. Now, the trick to using, these is to make sure that your ink pad is not too wet. And I believe I have re-inked this since then. And of course, being the person that I am, and you know, trying to keep things honest here, you know, I haven't even tried it. So even though these look perfect, they might not when I do it. So let's see. Yes, Susan, here, I'm going to go back to this only because Susan asked. And if Susan asked, that means somebody else might be thinking this too. This piece and this piece are attached to each other first, right? I put them together, and you don't have to put them together really, really well, mainly, you know, around the edges. I just put them together with snail adhesive because usually you would use something like liquid glue whenever something is textured like this. However, when I put it on the card base, I used liquid glue. But no, I put these two together, the Blackberry Bliss and the Very Vanilla, and then I run them through together. And that way, because what happens is all this up and down, all that real estate has to come from somewhere. So it just kind of like if you had a blanket here, you know, you go and you pick up the blanket and the edges of the blanket come in. Well, that happens when you do these embossing folders as well. It's not quite as noticeable, except for if there's a lot of embossed area like this one, and this one's very deep. So if I put them both through together, life is good. There you go. So back to this 1.5 by 5.5, right? Put them together. It doesn't matter if they're exactly the same. There is no law that says they're exactly the same. You know, I've slept since then. So let's see. How did I do that? Oh golly, and I better test this. Here. Director Dog. Whoops. Director Dog, where is my plain paper? Where is my plain paper? I have lots of grid paper over here. Yay. Is this it? Yes, you're such a good boy. I love him more and more every day. Okay, so here we go. See, look at how that even washes out the black there. Unfortunately, I did not get ones that that dimmed, and I realized that after I ordered them. Hop, see, look, see? But with these ones that are etched, you know, like they're really real, you don't want this to be really wet. But this one, it's working, even though I did re-ink it but since the last time I used it. If that is the case, you can take a spoon and just kind of work it and slide it across like this and then try to move the ink away so that, you know, yeah, that's one way. A credit card might work, you know, so. Okay, third time's a charm here. Now remember, I have slept since then. So I put one up here, right? And then I put one down there. I'm going to come back to that in a second. Are any of you having a hard time opening these? Because when you first get them, they can be a little stiff. You can put a little bit of, like take a candle and just go right down the side, and that will help. I wouldn't mess with it too much because you know how the old ones would just go kind of crazy? Yeah. You know, you want them to be a little bit tight, but when I open it, I just open it like that. And I have weak hands, so there. So here's the other one. I'm going to test it over here. Yep. This one, maybe I didn't re-ink it, but probably should. So here, I'm going to put this one right in the middle. Right? Okay. Now I'm going to turn it around. Right? And then I'm going to doesn't have to be exactly right. There you go. Yeah, that's, I'm not done yet. Get these up here. And if it separates, it's no big deal. It's not, you know. And I think I'm going to put this one here. Okay. Now, I could have done the same thing with the green, you know, for the leaves, but I didn't want just a tail of a leaf. I wanted the leaf, you know, and I kind of like to have them all go out together. So this, it just depends on how each one went. Oh, look it. I kind of goofed on that. That's because I let it go off the edge, but that's okay. I think they overlapped. But these are mainly, you know, you might as well say they're just the same. Of course, that never happened. Okay. That overlap never happened in 22 cards. But let me turn a television camera, I mean a Facebook Live camera on, and yeah. So do you see how that would be easy? And look at, it looks like they're all individually done. Now you could do it like a one sheet wonder, right? You could do it like that. The only thing is that then you really have no control over the color balance. And for me, I balance that color just the way I wanted to. There's slightly more pink. Actually, there's an equal amount of pink that there is Blackberry Bliss. And so I wanted it the way I wanted it there. And to me, it looks like my grandmother's old, like apron or something. See, and look at, I think that didn't happen to me either when I was doing it. So, hey, you know, how do you like that? Do you think that would help you if you were going to, you know, those of you who are coming up to, we're having Stampin' Up's version of convention coming up in April. And I'm going to be in Salt Lake City, and people who are Stampin' Up! Demonstrators, you know, make sure you come over and say hello. And some of my team is going to Salt Lake with me, and others are going to other spots. I almost went to Charlotte, where my husband's from, and then I also thought about going to Vancouver, British Columbia, which is where we had our honeymoon. Yep. Hold on. Let's see. There you go. So I hope that helped you, you know, because for those of you, you know, because for me, when I swap, I try to go and give somebody something that I would really like to have. Now, if you don't want to miss us next time, make sure that, oh, golly, thank you, Stamper, that if you're on Facebook, type stamp this below in the comments or use this link. There's a link below if you're over there on YouTube, yeah. And hey, Stamper, we did have a gift for today, right? We had a prize patrol, right? Yeah, yep. Okay. You know, I do want to ask you, did any of you watch the Oscars? If you didn't watch the Oscars, I'm sure that you've seen things, you know, that will stick in your head. It's almost like, you know, Stamper. We could be Bradley Cooper and Lady Gaga. If you just turn your head this way and we'll start singing. I'm sure Bradley Cooper doesn't shed. Oh, that's funny. Well, it is me. So, I have a... Yeah, these are some tutti-frutti sequins that already have adhesive on the back, and they're all, I just took them out of the package because that kind of looked, yeah. Ooh, boy, what color is that? Lovely lipstick? I think it is. So let's go over here and First, I got to get my number together. Those of you, this works for those of you on Facebook and on YouTube. For those of you who show up live, we're live every Wednesday at 1 o'clock Pacific time. And let's see if I can count these. Hold on. Talk amongst yourself. Okay. I can never remember whether there's 25 or 20 of these to a. Oh great, now two. Okay. And the magic number is. Now you're going to make me do math. Oh, golly. You know, I do math okay, but not when I have so many buttons to push. Okay, 75. Oh, let's just say, I'm going to count from the back. So we're just going to say an even 100. There you go. Make this big. Yeah, I went and worked on the cameras a little bit now that I've got the new new lighting, but okay, 33. So let me go and I'm gonna put this up for a minute while I count. But you still gotta be here. Oh, is someone new? Sarah, are you still here? It's somebody new. Isn't that great? You see, I see all these names and I'm looking at your responses and see if I can, you know, I don't look at, oh my goodness, so-and-so is saying something. I look at your comment and see if I can relate to that, you know. Okay, so, you know, the button police are over there on YouTube, and she's talking to you guys. It's funny because it's funny now. By the way, Sarah, if you're still on here, you want to make sure and say something, because otherwise I'm going to have to pick another one. And this is you, Sarah. Anyway, what's I gonna say? Oh yeah, on Facebook, a lot of you watch, and then a few watch afterwards, right? You know, a few watch a lot watch the next day, and then a few watch afterwards. On YouTube, a few watch, and then everybody watches after that. Oh golly! So let me go back and see if she's up here. You know, I just need a producer. I have a director. Sarah. So we're going to give you like yep. I put her name up there twice, so I'm going to go get me another number. Oh, sorry. I didn't show it to you, but there it is. 60. Yeah, that's a number. You know, they made a song about that. So talk amongst yourselves while I go and now I have to count again, unless Sarah came in at the last minute. No, she did not. Okay. But this time I'm going to count from the other end. Ha! I think this person's here. Hold on. Are you still here, Margaret? Otherwise, we'll just go save them for Friday. Because a lot of you come on Friday. And remember, it's Friday at 1 p.m. Margaret's usually here for most of the time. There she is. Hey. She was here 17 seconds ago. So I think that she's here now. Now, if I've mailed something for you, Margaret, that's okay. I'll just go get it in the mail. But if I haven't, make sure you contact me. And just, it's really easy. It's Anne, there, at stamperdog.com, okay? And at stamperdog.com. There, yeah. And so anyway, I am so glad that you came and hung out with me. We're only going to do 30 minutes instead of the regular 45. I'm just, oh my, oh, see, look at, she said, oh my goodness. So anyway, I am so glad that you hang out with me. Remember to go and type stamp this below if you're on Facebook and you would like to have a reminder just before we go live. Especially you want to do it for this Friday because you never know what we're going to show. It could be that one stamp set or that one accessory that you wanted to buy and you never did. So, you know, just, oh. And whatever you do, just be careful out there, whether you're in the pouring rain like we are here in California, and, you know, they're watching the rivers, or you're just being inundated with all that snow. Just know, I'm sending you sunshine in my heart. God bless. This is Ann Clemmer and Stamper Dog, where we put a little ink, paper, and fun, woo, into your day. Yes!